Yeah, I know I'm super late, but that's in the past now, okay? Today, we are going to be ranking the McLaren MCL38 in the Haas VF-24. That is right, the F1 season is nearly upon us. So leave a like and subscribe. Otherwise, this will live rent-free in your head all season.
Up and down, side to side, like a roller coaster.
All right, starting off with the McLaren. This was released back in January. I want to say like January 26th. Anyway, we're going to watch the video that they put on their website, and then we're going to take a look at some of the angles of the car. Oh, that was a clean transition. Oh, that was pretty cool. Obviously, it is not the same as last year. They have gotten rid of all of the blue, which as a blue enjoyer myself, it's a little bit of a sad day, but I think the rest of the livery speaks for itself when it's actually really good. It's taking inspiration from the stealth mode livery that was seen in Singapore last year, and with the chrome numbers, it's taking inspiration from the chrome livery in Silverstone. You can see there, it's got the chrome numbers, which I actually really like the font for. It's very cool. The orange front wing with the black as well. I think it's like a very sleek car. The silver is very cool. The chrome is very cool. But other than that, that's actually a pretty good shot. Other than that, it's just, it's good. I like it. But if they wanted to really surprise people with a surprise launch, you kind of need to have a better livery than that. No hate, I think it's a good livery, and it's a good start for the livery reveals this season, but... And so here's what we're going to do now. We are going to put this livery into a tier list. We've only got two right now, but here are the tiers. We've got incredible, good, meh, bad, and the 2023 title fight. That is the worst of the worst. And the McLaren, I'm going to give a number rating and I'm going to put it on the tier list, but let's go tier list first. I'm going to put it in good. I don't think it's great. I don't think it's incredible. It's not that bad, but we're going to get some better ones as the off-season ends. Right, and what number rating am I giving this? I'm going to give this McLaren MCL38 a 7 out of 10. It's a step down from last year where I believe I gave him like an 8 out of 10. But, you know, still a decent car. I really hope that they can stick it to Red Bull this season and Lando Norris can finally get his win. He deserves it so badly. But that's enough of what I think of the livery. What do other people think of the livery?
Yo, what's up?
Everyone, this is Sleepy24 from the Speed Draw video. Loser from the speed draw video. How do you feel about losing, Besnik?
Not great. You don't have to rub it in, Bes.
I didn't win either, okay? Yeah. Anyway, we're here to rate some cars today, so I'm gonna share my screen and we're gonna take a look at them.
Right.
Starting off with the McLaren.
One is three.
Two. I'm gonna give you a bunch of angles.
Ooh, that looks clean. I'm gonna give it a 9 out of 10.
A 9 out of 10?
Mm-hmm.
Higher than mine, I give it a 7 out of 10.
I mean, it's the same car. I mean, as much as you believe it's not the same car, it's the same car, you know?
And now, on to the Haas. Very similar to last year, and usually the first one to reveal, but McLaren beat them to it this year. Let's take a look at some angles, because we don't really have a video to go off of. Because Haas love their digital renderings. So that's the top view. As you can see, it looks very, very similar to last year from the top. But from the front and the side, you can tell there's some differences. First of all, absolutely love this black. It's just, like, super sleek and streamlined, and I actually really like it. The white on the halo is a nice touch. The red, I actually like that it's, like, kind of like a secondary color. I mean, it was a secondary color last year in the past few years, but, like, there's not a lot of red, which is good because I don't think the black and the red would merge very well, and I'm glad there's some pieces of white to, like, break it up as well. I think it's very good. But here you can see that they don't have a lot of sponsors. Like, it's a very empty car. They've got the huge Haas. They've got MoneyGram, again, with the nice little thing. They've got Chipotle. They got... what else do they got? They got whatever, the Play and Go. They got Palm Inn. That's, like, basically it. Yeah, it's, like, an empty car, but I think it's a very, like, good-looking car. There's the back view. Nothing special there. There's the view again. Chipotle. And those are two side-by-side. Kevin Magnussen's and Nico Hülkenberg's. And that's all the digital renderings we got to see for now. Now, back to the tier list. It's definitely not 2023 title fight. It's not bad. It's not meh. But it's not incredible either. It's good. We've got two entries into the good category on our first two visits to F1 livery ratings. And the Haas number rating, I'm actually going to move it ahead of the McLaren because the livery rating I'm giving to the Haas VF-24 is 7.5 out of 10, whole 0.5 more than the McLaren. Again, not the best thing in the world, but definitely not the worst thing in the world. And now, back to Besnik.
Ooh.
And then we've got...
this is home.
That view. This one's my favorite.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to go with that one. 9.5.
9.5? You're like the exact same as me. I gave the McLaren a 7, and I gave this one a 7.5.
They both look amazing.
They're very good, yeah.
I think that one.
The black is just so, like, streamlined and sleek. It's really cool. And then we've got 8 more coming before March, so we'll see.
All right,
that's basically it. Thank you for your insight. And, yeah. Anyway, that is going to be it for this video. If you guys did enjoy, make sure to leave a like and subscribe to the channel. There will definitely be some more livery ratings and reveals coming in the near future. Sorry this one took me so long, but hopefully I can get faster with them. And as always, goodbye. And beware of the Dutch national anthem. It's coming for you.